So hi dear Aries, a very very good evening to you guys. This is Anjali Tarot and this is a journal you versus them energy check-in for all the Aries Sun, Moon, Venus, Rising from today till the next 72 hours. It's valid for every like sign, like if even if you're dealing with another Aries, it's valid for you guys. So let's start. Let's see on your side what we have. Aries, on your side what we have. We got the Eight of Cups and the Queen of Swords and the Star card. So on your side, Aries, you're trying to walk away from something or someone and you're trying to cut somebody out of your life and you're trying to heal yourself. It's something that's hurting you again and again, and no matter how hard you're trying to make this work out, it's not working out. And now you're kind of fed up from this. Now you're kind of very, very sure, very, very clear in your intentions that you don't want to deal with this situation anymore, right? And you just feel like, okay, letting it go, moving on from the situation and like cutting the crap out of your life is very, very important for you. And healing yourself is very important for you right now at this present moment. So you are in this energy of, even if it is something or someone who might be with you from a very long time, you are not in the mood of taking any crap from this person's side. It's very painful for you to carry around this with these kind of energies. And you're like, I'm done with this shit. I have to let it go. I have to get out of this situation and I have to heal myself. You're very hopeful and positive though about the future direction of your relationship and love area. But with a specific energy, with a specific person, you are kind of done and you are kind of, it's in this very conscious kind of energy of, I cannot deal with this anymore, so I have to let it go. I'm sorry about the background noises. Please bear with me for a few days. Let's see the energy attached to you, what they are up to. The energy attached to you, what they are up to. Aries, we have the Justice and the Hanged Man and the Page of Swords. The energy attached to you is like they are doing, according to them, they are doing the right thing by being stagnant in this connection. I don't know what that means. This is someone who is kind of keeping you stuck, or they are stuck in the situation. They're watching you from a distance. They're kind of stalking you online. They're getting everything every kind of detail as possible from their side about you, what you are up to and what you are dealing with these days. But this is somebody who is kind of not participating very much, like actively in the situation, and they're kind of watching you from a distance. This is somebody who's definitely stalking you, but this is someone who's definitely stalking you, and they are in this energy of by stalking you and by not saying anything about the situation between you and them, they're doing the right thing. It could be very much possible that you're getting married or you're getting engaged or you're having somebody else in your life. That is why you're leaving the situation. Or might be they left you because of that kind of energy. Now they are watching you from a distance and they are thinking like, this is the only solution. This is the only solution left in the situation. And this is the only thing that they can do about it. This person is trying to see this whole situation, relationship dynamic between you and them from a fresh perspective, from a different angle. Okay, but it's kind of difficult for them to deal with kind of energy, but according to them, they are doing the right thing by not doing anything about it. Let's see for the connection what we have. We have the Ace of Cups, the Knight of Pentacles, and the Eight of Wands. For the connection, we have this. If you guys are ready to talk it out, if you guys are ready to communicate properly with each other, and if you guys are ready to be vulnerable in front of each other, very honestly and openly, I think this situation has the potential to regain the strength again. Now the potential of this situation is going down because of the communication issues, or one of you is not cooperating in the situation. There is no equal give and take of energy. This situation has the potential to become something in the near future. So if you guys can talk it out, if you guys can be open and honest with your person, with your with the other person's energy here, there are very good chances that the situation is going to have a brand new beginning. It's going to be slow and steady kind of energy, but it has the potential. So don't ruin it just because it's not working out right now. It's never going to work out. So please keep that in mind. And this situation has the potential to grow in a certain direction. So try to fix it if you can. Obviously, it's going to take two energies to tango. But again, the universe is telling me For you guys, that this situation has a good potential to become something very stable and solid, so you can make this work out if you want to, both of you, right? If you guys seriously want to make this work out, you guys can. Okay, let's see the guidance for you guys. Slowly but surely, this situation is going to give you this lesson of that communication is the key in any kind of situation, in any kind of relationship, in your love and any area of your life. If you are having some kind of connection with anybody, even if it is just friendship, plain friendship kind of energy, communication is the key for you guys. Let's see the guidance for you guys, Aries. We have the Page of Pentacles, the Death card, and the Six of Pentacles. The guidance here is, don't play the games like kids. If something is not working out, try to sort it out on an adult level, on a mature level, on a grounded level, okay? If something is not working out, you need to ask yourself very important questions. Why is it not working out? Why this situation is highly imbalanced? What is wrong with you? What is wrong with the other person? What is to tackle here? Okay, instead of trying to manipulate the other person, trying to blame the other person, trying to blame the whole universe for the situation, it's time for you to go inside of you and understand what's working for you and what's not working for you as a human in regards to love and relationship, and then try to fix it. Okay, not the other person, not everybody else, but yourself. Cool. So thank you so much for tuning in, Aries. I'll see you soon in the next video. Bye bye, take care, God bless you, namaste.